What is actually Golden Boy about?
Golden Boy is about a boy, you know, Joe Bonaparte. Usko confusion to be a violinist or to be a boxer. So it's a dilemma.
Highly high entertainment ko aba upcoming plans hai ke
chha? Upcoming plans haru dherai chha aile lai haina tara definitely movies ra art related hai huncha hamro highly high ko further kaam haru haina. So yeah, aba aile yo play I'm more focused on your play. So this pachi balla ma September 10th dekhi balla ma aru cheez har ma focused hunchu bhanera basyo kinane maile script call pani gareko the haina ra yo August ko end samma ma sabai script lockdown garera ani tyo finalize garnu parne cha. So it's going to be after this play. So next could be movie.
Ani hajurle yo bhanda pahila kun kun drama haru garnu bhako thiyo?
Maile pahila Lady from the Sea, Oleanna, Yerma ani yo.
Tyo pahila ko drama haru bhanda yo kati ko difference cha?
पहिलाको ड्रामा भन्दा यो डिफ्रेन्टै छ किनभने 1930सको अमेरिकन प्ले हो यो होइन र हामीले त्यही अटायर त्यही लुक्समा हामीले पोर्ट्रे गर्न खोजेको छ हाम्रो सबै क्यारेक्टरहरू 1930सकै लुक्समा हुनुहुन्छ प्लस जुन चाहिँ यो कन्सेप्ट छ इट्स डिफ्रेन्ट किन भन्दाखेरि बारमा कहिले पनि प्ले भएको थिएन लाउन्जमा होइन यो कर्मा बार एन्ड लाउन्ज हो सो यसमा यो ठाउँमा प्ले हुँदैछ फर द फर्स्ट टाइम र प्ले हुँदाहुँदै बियरहरू पनि सर्भ गरिँदैछ किन भन्दाखेरि यो प्ले नै इट्स अबाउट बक्सिङ इट्स अबाउट म्युजिक अनि 1930सकै इट्स अल अबाउट ड्रिङ्किङ एन्ड स्मोकिङ सो त्यसले गर्दाखेरि चाहिँ हामीले एक्सपेरिमेन्ट गरिरहेको यो कस्तो हुन्छ अब लेट्स सी
हाइली हाई इन्टरटेनमेन्टले पहिला मुभी बनाउने कुरा थियो अनि अहिले चाहिँ ड्रामा किन
होइन यस्तो छ हामीले पहिला मुभी बनाइसकेको अहिले मुभी नै मुभी बनाउनु इज लाइक वी निड लट्स अफ रिसर्च क्या होइन पहिला मैले सोल सिस्टर भन्ने मुभी बनाइसकेको जुनबाट म त्यति खुसी थिइनँ र त्यो एक्सपिरियन्सले अब मलाई एउटा अब मैले फिल्म बनाउँदाखेरि केही राम्रै होस् द्याट सुड मेक सेन्स भनेर म राम्रो स्क्रिप्ट कुरिरहेको थिएँ र अहिले एकदम राम्रो राम्रो स्क्रिप्ट आइरहेको छ आई निड टु थ्याङ्क अडियन्स किनकि मैले यो मेरो फ्यान पेजमा स्क्रिप्ट कल गरेको थिएँ त्यहाँबाट एकदमै राम्रो स्क्रिप्टहरू आएको छ तर हामी अब सर्टलिस्ट गर्छौँ अनि यो प्ले पछि गर्छौँ किनभने यो प्ले चाहिँ मलाई 2013 कुरा आएको थियो होइन र डेब्राले मलाई एकदमै काम गर्नु मन लाग्थ्यो यो टिमसँग डेब्राहरूसँग म पहिला ओलियाना पनि डेब्राले नै डिरेक्ट गरेको सो त्यसले गर्दाखेरि चाहिँ एज एन आर्टिस्ट मैले एक्सप्लोर गर्ने ठाउँ पाउँछु थिएटरमा त्यो भएर चाहिँ वाइ नट भनेर
अनि हजुरको एक्सपिरियन्स चाहिँ कस्तो थियो अमृत दाहाल न्यू एक्टरसँग
नर्मली अब मैले फिल्महरूमा पनि नयाँ एक्टर्सहरूसँग काम गरिसकेको छु र थिएटरमा पनि त्यो भएकोले गर्दाखेरि मलाई त्यस्तो खासै गाह्रो त भएन र अमृत दाहाल उसको कुरा गर्नुपर्दा हि इज भेरी हार्ड वर्किङ र एकदमै सिक्न खोज्छ होइन एभ्री टाइम हि कम्स एन्ड लाइक आस लाइक के गर्दा बेटर हुन्छ मेरो यो मिल्यो कि मिलेन सो हि इज भेरी इन्थुजियास्ट अनि अलिक हार्ड वर्किङ हुनुहुन्छ र आई थिङ्क यो रोलको लागि उहाँ पर्फेक्ट हुनुहुन्छ
थ्याङ्क यू
Warmly welcome all members of the press.
Hello.
And representatives of the journalism fraternity. We thank you for giving your time to attend our press meet. And before I start, I would like to at least give you the outlay of the program today. I shall be giving a short introduction to the play that we are doing today. And do you have the paper on your hand, which also gives you a fair bit of details about what the play is about and about the actors that are present in the play? The Golden Boy, which we shall be hosting on Karma Lounge on the 1st of September to the 10th of September. And this play, it is actually follows the protagonist, Joe Bonaparte, his life as a from a musician to a brutal boxer. And it also looks at the theme of conflict between art and fame. As you have it in the paper, you can read the following on what Clifford Odette's play is about, and we shall also have Upal Chha to elaborate more on Clifford Odette's. And I would like to also give a short introduction to One World Theatre. One World Theatre is a non-profit English language theatre company in Kathmandu, dedicated to presenting intercultural social justice production, especially plays from South Asia, the Western canon, and contemporary American plays that are affordable, professional, experimental, and relevant. Recent productions include Arjuna's Dilemma, which was written by Douglas C. Cuomo, and Nepal's first opera featuring a fusion of Western and Eastern music. The Laremi project 10 years later by Moises Kaufman and Tectonic Theatre Company. A true story about gay rights and hate crimes in the US, which we all are very aware of what is happening around in America nowadays. And also features the stories from Nepali LGBTIQ people. Paniko Kunzan was written by Rajkumar Padaisani, an educational outreach Nepali play about water sanitation in Patan, based on research from the Patan Academy of Health Sciences with the support of Oxford University and Clinical Research Center. And The Diary of Annie Frank, written by Albert Hackett and Francis Goodrich, about a Jewish family living in hiding during the Holocaust, based on the very true story of diary writings of the young girl who lived it firsthand. Now, I would like to call upon the stage, as I shall be introducing all the actors. First, I would like to call upon on stage Namrata Shrestha, playing the female lead of Lorna Moon and the MD of Highly High Entertainment. Next, I would like to call upon Mr. Rajkumar Padaisani, who is playing the role of Mr. Bonaparte. Next, I would like to call upon Mr. Suraj Arya, who is playing the role of Tokyo. All apologies for the absence of one of our lead actor, Mr. Alejandro E. Merola, who is absent here because he's taken ill today. So instead, I shall also be introducing one of our newest lead actors, Mr. Amrit, who is playing the role of Joe Bonaparte. I would also like to call upon on stage Mrs. Deborah Merola, the founder and artistic director of One World Theatre. And I would also like to take this opportunity to extend a very, very warm welcome to an illuminary of the boxing world, who is a California Boxing Hall of Fame and the World Boxing Hall of Fame. Please give a warm welcome to Mr. Yaki Lopez. I would now like to hand over a mic to the panel, and starting with Deborah Merola, who would like to say a few words.
Thank you, Vikash, for the warm introduction, and to Highly High Entertainment, and to the Karma Bar and Lounge for hosting and producing our environmental production, site-specific production of Golden Boy by Clifford Odets. A site-specific production means that it is conceived, imagined, designed for a particular space. And when you all are not sitting there, there will be a 12 by 12 boxing ring and an actual demonstration about of boxing. And Mr. Lopez, Yaki Lopez, has been helping us today, and also the Naxal Boxing Club, who will send 2-3 professional fighters, and also Gymkhana. So we have a lot of friends. It is particularly meaningful to me that Namrata and I are joining in this production as producer and director and lead actor of Lorna Moon. Namrata was in the very first One World Theatre production in November 2011, when we produced Oleanna, and she played the lead role against Amrit and a magnificent actor in that. She also went on for One World Theatre to perform in Yerma, and Rajkumar Pudasani was also in that production. It was in Nepali and with a guest director, Bimal Subedi. So this is a kind of return to have such a celebrated and beautiful and gifted actor is a real privilege. The play itself is important in American history and it is iconic. It stands for a lot in the history of American drama. It was written in 1935. It had a recent Broadway revival in 2012. It's a forerunner of Death of a Salesman as a play. It really, its subject is the American dream, so admired here in Nepal, and what happens when the American dream goes to the dark side. So it is a discussion of fame and fortune, of the gold bug, of the streets paved with gold, that the theme of Golden Boy has to do with money and fame, and it also has to do with art. And what I had said is that it's relevant, I believe, for Nepal, because our fine actors here, including Amrit the Hall introducing him, and all of our actors who are here in the area. So, and it's a struggle, as you all probably know in the press. It's a struggle to have a free press. It's a struggle to have a democracy, and it's a struggle to remain an actor who pursues truthful success, which is the mantra of our play. Thank you.
I would like to also take this opportunity to request Namrata Shrestha to just say a few words, and please forgive her because like she's not feeling well at the moment, but she's doing her level best. Thank you so much, Namrata, for being with us here today.
First of all, I'd like to thank everyone who is present here. Thank you so much for your time. I would like to thank Deborah and all the actors for supporting the play, because it's always a pleasure to work with One World Theatre. Since I'm an artist, I love different forms of art. So theater was something that I always wanted to do. That's why I took a break from movie and now I'm here in theater. So it's gonna start from September 1st till September 10th and I hope you guys will support us. Thank you all. Thank you so much.
Rajkumar Pudasani to say a few words.
Golden Boy, American classic, 1935 को story. हमी चाहिँ अहिले जस्तो नेपालको 2074 साल 2017 मा काठमाडौँको यो स्टेजमा मञ्चन गर्दैछु. यसको पछाडि के कारणहरू छन् म त्यो चाहिँ भन्न चाहन्छु. Golden Boy American life मा एउटा चाहिँ हुन्छ नि आफूलाई अगाडि बढाउन खोज्ने आफ्नो मनको कुरा आफूले चाहेको कुरा गर्न परिवारबाट पनि पन्छिएर जस्तो बाबुआमाको आदेशभन्दा पनि बाहिर गएर आफ्नो कुरा चाहिँ मलाई मन परेको कुरा मलाई चाहिएको कुरा गर्नको लागि सङ्घर्ष गर्ने एउटा केटाको कथा हो. त्यो सङ्घर्ष पोलिटिक्समा पनि हुन्छ, थिएटरमा पनि हुन्छ, एक्टिङमा पनि हुन्छ, पेन्टिङमा पनि हुन्छ, सायद कवि कलाकारहरू सबैमा हुन्छ, बिजनेसमा पनि हुन्छ, इन्डस्ट्रियलहरूमा पनि हुन्छ. त्योमध्येको यो चाहिँ बक्सी प्रोफेसनभित्रको त्यो सङ्घर्ष कथा हामी देखाउँदैछौँ. यो गरिरहँदाखेरि हामी मलाई पर्सनल्ली कलाकारको रूपमा के फिल हुन्छ भनेदेखि म पनि घरबाट भागेर आएको, मैले घरबाट फाइट गरेर आफ्नो मन लागेको कुरा गर्नुको लागि थिएटरमा आएको. तर मैले मन लागेको गर्ने ठाउँ अथवा मलाई मन परेको गर्ने ठाउँ कस्तो छ, त्यो कतिको दूषित छ, त्यो कतिको सफा छ, त्यहाँभित्र कतिको अनेस्टी छ, त्यहाँभित्र कतिको हार्डवर्किङ छ, र त्यहाँभित्र कतिको चाहिँ एकले अर्कालाई कतिको ह्युमन व्यवहार गर्छ, त्यो महत्त्वपूर्ण कुरा हो जुन कुरामाथि हामी यो नाटकमाथि खेल्छौँ. र त्यो हाम्रोमा पनि छ, ताकि कसैको चाहिँ एउटा हुन्छ नि आफ्नो चाहना हुन्छ भने उसलाई कसरी युज गर्छ मान्छेहरू, जसले केही समय बिताइसकेको छ त्यही काममा जस्तो फेम एन्ड फर्च्युनको लागि जसले आफ्नो सपना पुरा गर्नको लागि एउटा ठाउँमा हुन्छ त्यो ठाउँमा उसलाई कतिको प्रयोग गरिन्छ उसलाई कतिको गाह्रो हुन्छ त्यो कथा यसले बोकेको छ जुन मैले जे गरेर आएँ नाटकमा त्यो कथा यो कथासँग रिलेभेन्ट छ त्यही भएर 1935 अथवा समय त्यो पनि अमेरिकामा होटेल्स जहाँ होटेल्स त्योसँग मतलब होइन मतलब चाहिँ त्यसको गुदी हामीलाई दिन्छ त्यही भएर हामी यहाँ मञ्चन गर्न कोसिस गर्दैछौँ यसलाई कृपया त्यो रूपमा लिइदिनु होला धन्यवाद
नाटकको बारेमा देवलाले पनि भनिसक्नुभयो राजमाजीले पनि भनिसक्नुभयो नमस्कार पनि भनिसक्यो र तपाईँहरूको हातमा जुन फ्लायर छ त्यति पनि बताइहाल्छ नाटकको बारेमा यो नाटक सेप्टेम्बर 1 सुरु हुँदैछ महत्त्वपूर्ण कुरा र 10 तारिक पनि सकिन्छ त्यस बिचमा तपाईँको सहयोग चाहिन्छ हामीले त्यो नाटक यो नेपाली नाटकलाई जसरी त्यो अङ्ग्रेजी नाटकलाई त्यो पनि अमेरिकाको नाटकलाई हामीले नेपालमा काठमाडौँमा गर्दैछौँ जस्तै राजमाझीले भनेको त्यो अनुसारले हामीले प्रस्तुत गर्न सक्यौँ वा सकेनौँ तपाईँहरूको चाहिँ एकदम क्रिटिकल्ली कमेन्ट्स अथवा सजेसन जे पनि छ त्यो चाहिँ हामीलाई आवश्यक हुन्छ त्यसको लागि नै अनुरोध गर्दछु अरू कुरा त नाटक हेरिसकेपछि नै हामीले बताउने छौँ हामीले बताउने कोसिस गर्छौँ बताउँछौँ म त्यति नै भन्न चाहन्छु
थ्याङ्क यू सो मच फर कमिङ एन्ड I would like to say that I'm really happy to be playing the role of Joe Bonaparte in this play, The Golden Boy. And I'm really happy to work with One World Theatre as well. I've been doing theatre since last 2 years and I'm really excited for this play because in this play we have amazing actors like Namrata Shrestha, So I'm really very happy to be a part of this play and I hope we'll get support from you all. And that's it. Thank you so much.
The person that I meet then, that's because they read a story in the New York Times about Bad City. There was a movie. That movie was filmed in 1969 and it was about boxing. And, The writer that he write that movie, he is my friend, I know him, and about 2.5 months or 3 months, the writer, he take another writer from the New York Times to the boxing game, and they take pictures, they talk, and anyway, they make a nice story about Fed City boxing game. So Deborah and his husband, they went to my game and they talked to me and they take a lot of pictures and they asked me if I'm interested to come to Namrata, and I say yes, and thanks to them, I'm here and I'm very happy to be here with some great people. All you guys very friendly, and I'm just happy just to be here. And thanks a lot, and I hope you guys support the play. Thank you.
Thank you. About audience. This guy, he started off as a wannabe actor. He wanted to be an actor and he started with different theaters and production, was really struggling to make it there. He would get casted as understudy in quite a few plays, but then unfortunately for him, the lead actors would never fail to not come to the rehearsals, and then he actually never got that chance that he was looking for. And that was probably the reason why he switched into writing, because he had like a lot of time to spare with, apart from those tiny little roles that he started doing. And that's how it began, writing for him. And he started basically with his theater group, with the plays that were like socially relevant, and the causes and the message-oriented plays, which got really popular. And that got like eyebrows popping back in the Hollywood, and they wanted him as the mainstream writer there. And So with that success, he went to Hollywood and he wrote for like many studio, which were like prevalent back then. And it was probably 8 to 9 years, and he just got fed up from that. And there have been like different analogies, different comparisons, that when he came back, he actually produced Golden Boy, which turned out to be a major, major success. And there have been like parallels which have been drawn with this, that there have been many theories that people say he could not have made it beyond this. And he was like a one-hit wonder, and there were like no gas left in him. But truth be told, who were actually near and dear to him, they said that he had many brilliant plots and he had them narrated to them. And he was on his course, but unfortunately he died and things got like south. But this about the Golden Boy, there are many theories that whatever frustrations and whatever underworld that he saw back in the Hollywood, all those underbellies, he was actually trying to portray through this one. And there were all his angst and frustrations and the politics around it, which got surrounded. It got like wrapped up in the boxing world. But then he was actually giving out all his angst and all his frustrations through that. And he actually was one of the founding members, or one of the last actors to be selected into group theater, which was spearheaded by Lee Strasberg, which actually started this acting. Lee Strasberg, as you would know, who got inspired from Konstantin Stanislavski in Russia, and brought actually method acting in the States. And he was one of the last actors who was actually inducted into it. In a way, I draw a lot of parallels as how this thing goes when you want to be artistic and you're really exploring different things into the acting and direction, and suddenly something happens. It also gives you idea of chance and how life can surprise you in ways. So yeah, Golden Boy, one of his most successful plays, and it has been produced in Nepal. I hope you like it. Really happy for Amrit here, who's doing Joe, the Golden Boy character, and he's doing some brilliant work with this cast here, cast ensemble, that is a bunch of really talented people, directed by Deborah Merola herself. I hope you guys support it, enjoy. Thank you very much.
तर फिल्मलाई भन्दा बढी नाटकलाई चाहिँ प्राथमिकतामा
होइन, यो कलाको एउटा फर्म त हो नि होइन, नाटक र मुभी, तर कला क्षेत्रमै छु म होइन. तर मैले 2014 गरेको थिएँ यर्मा भन्ने, सो 2 वर्षपछि गर्दैछु यो, 2 वर्ष 3 वर्षपछि. सो मलाई जहिले पनि थिएटर भन्ने बित्तिकै म सानो संसारको टाइमदेखि एकदमै अट्र्याक्टेड थिएँ. गुरुकुलमा म जहिले पनि प्ले हेर्न जान्थेँ, राजकुमारदाईहरूको प्ले हेरेर आउँथेँ मैले होइन, सौगताईहरू मलाई एकदम रमाइलो लाग्थ्यो. सो त्यो टाइमदेखि नै मलाई थिएटरमा इन्ट्रेस्ट थियो, र जहिले पनि मुभीबाट टाइम मिल्यो भने म थिएटर गरिहालौँ जस्तो लाग्छ मलाई. त योपालि चाहिँ मैले मुभीलाई साइड लगाएर नै थिएटर गरेको, किनकि डेब्राले मलाई यो 2013 भएको कुरा थियो, यो गोल्डन बोय भन्ने प्लेको कुरा होइन, त्यो बेलादेखि पेन्डिङ भइरहेको थियो. सो यो टाइम चाहिँ मलाई राइट टाइम जस्तो फिल भयो, अनि आफूलाई पनि एज एन एक्टर एक्सप्लोर गर्न मन थियो. यो लोर्ना मुन भन्ने क्यारेक्टर मलाई एकदमै इन्ट्रेस्टिङ लागेको थियो होइन, सो त्यसले गर्दाखेरि चाहिँ वाइ नट भनेर एउटा राम्रो टिम छ, सबैजना सबैले सपोर्ट गर्नुभएको छ, सो टिम राम्रो लाग्यो, कन्सेप्ट राम्रो छ, सबै चिज राम्रो भएर म फेरि थिएटरमा आएको.
यस कारणले टपिला सनराइज अलिक पछाडि सरेको.
हजुर, म अहिले चाहिँ यो September 10 म कुनै पनि स्क्रिप्ट पनि हेरिरहेको छुइनँ, फिल्म पनि साइन गरेको छुइनँ, मैले सबैलाई होलमै राखेको छु. सो 2-3 कुरा भइरहेको छ, तर मेबी आफ्टर द्याट यो प्ले सक्यो म अहिले यसमा मात्रै फोकस गर्न चाहन्छु. त्यही भएर
निर्माणतिरै लाग्नुभएको छ नि तपाईँको.
हजुर हजुर,
आगामी दिनमा नाटक निर्माणको सोच बनाएको छ.
मेरो सोच त छ वर्षमा एउटा नाटक गर्ने भन्ने मैले सोच बनाएको छु होइन, यस्तै राम्रो कन्सेप्ट स्क्रिप्टहरू छ र यस्तो टिम पाएँ भने त वाइ नट, वर्षमा एउटा म थिएटर गर्छु.
फिल्ममा लभ स्टोरी वा लभ स्टोरी भूमिकामा वा प्रेमिकाको भूमिकामा देखिरहेको छ, नाटकमा चाहिँ तपाईँको त्यही भूमिका छ वा अलिक फरक?
फरक खालको प्रेमिकाको भूमिका छ, इट्स अप टु यु गाइज। तर जुन किसिमले हामीले मेहनत गरेको छौँ, सबै एक्टरले जुन किसिमले रात दिन यहाँ बिहान दस बजीदेखि पाँच बजीसम्म बसेर रिहर्सल गर्छौँ, त्यो हेर्दाखेरि चाहिँ राम्रो बनेको छ जस्तो लाग्छ र अडियन्सले पनि मन पराउनुहुन्छ जस्तो लाग्छ। किनकि यो आई थिङ्क दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम इन नेपाल जहाँ चाहिँ हामीले बारमा प्ले गर्दैछौँ होइन, अन टप अफ द्याट हामीले बियर पनि सर्भ गर्दैछौँ ड्युरिङ द प्ले, किनभने यो त्यो एराको प्ले भएकोले गर्दाखेरि सो वी आर ट्राइङ समथिङ न्यू, लेट्स होप अब इट्स एन एक्सपेरिमेन्ट, अब अडियन्सले रुचाउनुहुन्छ जस्तो लाग्छ मलाई।
आई थिङ्क यसमा चाहिँ जो बोना पार्टी जो चाहिँ लिड क्यारेक्टर छ गोल्डन बोयको, ऊ चाहिँ खासमा म्युजिसियन हुन्छ, ऊ एकदमै राम्रो भर्जनिस्ट हुन्छ, बट टु गेट हिज इन्ट्रेस्टेड टु गेट फेम एन्ड फर्च्युन, पैसा गाडी, त्यसकै लागि ऊ बक्सिङमा इन्ट्रेस्टेड भएर बक्सिङमा जान्छ। एन्ड आई थिङ्क ग्याट्सबीसँग अलिअलि मिल्दोजुल्दो छ, बिकज दे बोथ ह्याभ अ ड्रिम टु बी सक्सेसफुल फेमस एन्ड टु डु समथिङ इन द वर्ल्ड, आई थिङ्क अलिअलि मिल्दोजुल्दो छ। थ्याङ्क यू
to call out Divya Dev and also Hemantha Shalis, Kokan Rama, Alize Biyamadis. Artists give up films to be in plays, as you all are. They give up money and they are dedicated to art. And these are the kind of people who build a theater company. And you all, as press, and with good articles, that's very helpful too. So thank you.
First, मैले पहिला जो बोना पार्टीको रोल पाएपछि आई डिन्ट नो सी वाज इन द कास्ट पहिला, तर पछि भने आई हर्ड द्याट नम्रता श्रेष्ठ इज डुइङ लोर्ना मुन भनेर, देन आई वाज रियल एक्साइटेड एन्ड नर्भस एज वेल, बिकज मैले भएको फिल्महरू गीतहरू फिल्मको गीतहरू हेरिरहेको छु, अनि आई वाज रियली नो एक्साइटेड प्लस नर्भस पनि थिएँ धेरै, बिकज सी इज अ एक्सपिरियन्स एक्टर अनि भेरी राम्रो राम्रो काम गर्नुहुन्छ, अनि तर मलाई लाग्थ्यो कि उहाँ एकदमै होइन टिममा हेर्दाखेरि त आई डिन्ट नो सी वाज सो नाइस डाउन टु अर्थ होइन, तर बट आफ्टर रिहर्सल्सहरू हुन थाल्यो भने मेट हर एन्ड देन सी इज भेरी डाउन टु अर्थ, भेरी नाइस, भेरी काइन्ड, एन्ड सी अल्सो बिकज सी इज अ एक्सपिरियन्स एक्टर, म त भर्खर नयाँ नयाँ हो, अनि सी टट मी अ लट अबाउट एक्टिङ, सी हेल्प मी अ लट, उहाँसँग काम गर्नु एकदमै राम्रो भयो, आई एम इन्जोइङ इट, थ्याङ्क यू।